Dr. Jason Saunders here with another 3-minute research review. Today we're going to talk about hyperbaric oxygen as it relates to fibromyalgia. The title of the research article is Hyperbaric Oxygen Therapy Can Diminish Fibromyalgia Syndrome Clinical Trial. So they were broken up into two groups, a treatment group and a control group. They were evaluated 3 times over the course of the trial. They were evaluated on quality of life, activities of daily living, pain and tenderness. As well, they did a SPECT scan for brain imaging, for brain metabolism, to understand areas of the brain that were hyperactive and areas of the brain that were hypo or not functioning enough metabolically. So the treatment plan was hyperbaric oxygen, 40 sessions, 5 days a week, 90 minutes each session, 100% oxygen at 2 ATA. There were 60 female patients, anywhere aging from 21 to 67. They needed to have fibromyalgia syndrome for a minimum of 2 years diagnosed prior to entering the study. There were significant improvements in all subjective tenderness tests. There was improvement in quality of life outcome measures. And then the analysis of SPECT imaging revealed rectification of any abnormal brain activity. In other words, the areas of decreased activity improved and the areas of increased or too much hyperactivity actually lessened. And so they saw a balancing on the SPECT scan. It says the study provides evidence that hyperbaric oxygen can improve the symptoms and the quality of life for fibromyalgia patients. Moreover, it shows that hyperbaric oxygen can induce neuroplasticity and significantly rectify abnormal brain activity in pain areas of fibromyalgia patients. So I think this study, and this is not the only one, but this study does absolutely show that fibromyalgia is helped with hyperbaric oxygen, and the mechanisms are very similar to other mechanisms that we've seen in other studies. Generally speaking, you're going to have an improvement in metabolic function of the brain. You're going to have a decrease of inflammation systemically, but also very specifically a decrease of inflammation in the nervous system itself. You're going to have increased blood flow to the brain, increased oxygen to the brain, increased capacity of brain function and signaling. You're going to find autonomic regulation, so balancing of the sympathetic, parasympathetic nervous system. And you're going to have an increase in metabolic function of the mitochondria. So as a result of long-term hyperbaric oxygen use, anywhere from 20 to 40 hours or more, you're going to get an increase in size of mitochondria. You're going to get an increase in efficiency of mitochondria. And most importantly, you're going to have an increase in density of mitochondria. In other words, your body's going to have more mitochondria so that you can utilize this excess of oxygen that's being brought into the system. So thank you very much, and we'll see you on the next research review.